It's TMNT time! Hello, welcome to another Figure View. Today we're going to have a look at the Super 7 Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Ultimate Michelangelo figure. The last turtle, wait, no, the second to last turtle of the bunch we're getting from Super 7, the Ultimates line. I have reviewed all of the entries so far, and I'm planning on reviewing everything else that's coming out of it. The TMNT logo, kind of like their own custom logo in the front with the nunchucks. Michelangelo, and it says TMNT. Warning, I don't know what that's all about. Got a nice slider, and then you got the classic style box. I say classic because it has like the wall around it. If you remember the old school boxes, you always had them burst out of the wall, but yes, this thing is beautiful. Got some nice green on it. Got the TMNT logo, bio on the back, Super 7, Nickelodeon, and some graffiti on the walls, and yes, it's Michelangelo. What do you gotta know about this guy? He's the party dude. He's a favorite, one of my favorites, and especially one of the favorites when most people were children. I remember how everybody was always like, oh, Mikey's my favorite, because, like, you know, he's fun-loving, like the light-hearted guy, cracks jokes and whatnot. So, that's about all I can say about him. Let's have a look at the figure, finally. Did you know that liking and subscribing videos increases your happiness? Okay, maybe that's not true, but it increases my happiness, so you should think about it at least. And then there's the turtle of the wave. I reviewed two of them already, and this one is, no different, but that's not a knock on it. Having a look at size, it's still my childhood favorite, Mikey, that is. 15 centimeters to the top of his head, which means we are going up to a little shy of 6 inches tall. Size comparisons. Here's Jolter, NECA Raphael, Super 7 Leonardo, Super 7 April, Super 7 Rocksteady, Mattel Stone Cold Steve Austin, and Darkseid. And after the size comparisons, I want to have the figure comparisons just to be safe, just to be sure. Yes, this does seem like the exact same old, just repainted, repackaged, and, slapped a different name on it. That's fine, it's common practice, I'm not, complaining about it, but then again, kids say, like, well, you have, like, the exact same thing going down, I don't know. I feel like it's a common thing, I'm not really bothered by it, I just want to double check on it. But yeah, it is the same thing. One thing I kind of find weird, like, they painted the metal parts in Leonardo's belt, which they added, and they didn't, they also kind of, like, molded it for Mikey, but they didn't paint it, so. What's up with the inconsistencies, guys? Then you got the black shell, and that's fine. Also, now getting over to another comparison. Here's the original Playmates toy, which I didn't have size comparisons, but there you go. You have it right there, right now. Want to have a look at it. It does look a lot more orange in the shell, but I don't know if that's like maybe because mine's old, maybe a lot more yellow back in the day. You got the exact same belt with all the holsters for his nunchucks, and some added detail in the newer ones, and obviously just nice muscle work. Damn, boy! And now, finally, I'm actually going to focus on the figure at hand, which is Michelangelo, as his belt kind of, it's kind of going up and down. Line up, please. Line up and be safe. Okay, is that connected over here somewhere? Like, it's not straight. It's going down. I have trouble getting it up. I still do have the classic hand on there. He does come with a little bit of a more modern one, but I like this one, and I just kind of want to keep it on. Now, the one thing I don't like about it is some of the paint issues. Look at this one, it's not clean. It's small and not really the worst thing in the world, but it is there. Also, there's some molded detail in the headbands, which is barely noticeable, but he's appreciated nonetheless. Looks good, standing out the teeth on one side, and it's just like this look. And he has like a lot sharper eyes though, this almost looks like Batman. Then we have the neck, has some detail on there. The black shell, which I'm really wondering, I did order Raph, the Raph re-release, even though I already have the original, because the original one had a brown shell, and now all the other ones have like a dark shell, a black shell, which the official toy, Playmates toy, had a black shell. So, kind of looking forward to that and seeing how that evolves. Then we go back to the muscle work in the arms. As I already pointed out, you got the veins, but really nice and detailed muscle work. I mean, it's a mold that I really appreciate. And you can tell that they really put a lot of work in the turtles. And, of course, because they should, because it's just going to repaint the same body 4 times, and that's the turtles. Then you have a little bit of shading in the shell, I feel like. It's getting a little bit darker in some of the you know, nooks and crannies. And you go to the belt, does not have the paint on there, as I mentioned beforehand, inconsistencies, and some more stuff in the back for the nunchucks. Down to the legs, I love all the muscle work that went into this, it's like super ripped. Also, the elbow and knee pads do have a nice amount of detail in there. It looks a little bit more like the movie in that one. That's another thing of like really updating the mold in general, because like the old one, yeah, you can kind of tell there's some lines, but it doesn't really stick out on the side. It's a lot more straight. So yeah, I like when I take some liberties like that and updating it and not like leaving it the exact same figure, so it just looks kind of like plain and boring. I don't really like when they're doing that. What are you doing here? But yeah, there's also some shading in the muscle work, but you barely see it on this guy because his skin is so dark. You can kind of tell with Leonardo, it's a little bit better, but it's the same thing. But you know, I just kind of went back on that because I didn't really focus on it. Now, for your articulation, the head moves back and forth, does tilt side to side, and it does go all the way around, but it's really freaking limited. You have to give a little bit of push. Also, this one is fairly loose. And you have the shoulder with the big hinge moves up and down, and you can rotate it in the socket all the way. Got a bicep swivel. One hinge in the elbow goes up and down, and also rotation with your hands, fist, whatever. It's kind of just, this one's frozen, I guess. Also, they do have the ones where it does go side to side. Does help with like posing, like nunchucks and swords, and I appreciate when they're doing it. Oh, that's why I couldn't move them, because I was moving them in the wrong direction, lol. Then we move down to the hip part. You can rotate that around, bring it a little bit to the side, and tilt it a little bit. It is fairly loose though, and it's not, doesn't accomplish that much, but hey, it is there, so that's fine. The leg moves forward, moves out to the side, doesn't move to the back because of the shell, and then you can rotate it also in the leg, and same thing, like the leg is, it's kind of floppy a little bit. Then you have the knee, which, yeah, why would you mold it like that? Why would you mold it on the, like over the knee pad? That just sucks, but yeah. And they do not fix that, obviously, and you can also rotate it on there because just packed in, it just looks so dumb. That's the biggest oversight in this entire mold. And then the foot moves back and forth. It is also fairly slippery, and I do have a little bit of issues, like, they don't really also tighten the joints, I feel like. Like, the posing overall is good, and it doesn't really fall apart. They still hold poses very nicely. Honestly, I have more trouble with NECA figures falling over, depending on the figure though. Like, the turtles have pretty big feet, so that usually doesn't happen. But what I'm saying is, like, especially in the feet and with the legs, I had, like, before I had Leonardo always, like, kind of standing, having, like, splits, and it's kind of hard to keep him in pose. He does tend to slip a little bit, so that's a thing I can now say, like, over time, they kind of have trouble holding some poses with the legs. It might slip a little bit. Doesn't fall over, doesn't just collapse or anything, but the tightness could be a little bit better. For your accessories, first of all, there's fist hands. I couldn't get those out, so there they are, fist hands. Oh, of course, now they want to work. You have some nunchucks with plastic chains, just molded on there, and then you have the weapons rack with the entire stuff in there, unpainted, looks like the old school toy. But then you have also the exact same amount of weapons in a new painted version. First and foremost, you have these things. I don't know the names of this. If you are more familiar with Japanese weaponry, let me know about it. Then you got this thing, which, yeah, it's a thing. It's a knife with like a hook on it. Again, Japanese weaponry. I am not familiar with the name. But then you have the nunchucks with the real chain, which I always do appreciate. Let's see, different headpiece. Like the more modern headpiece, they own kind of slice of it, which does have some paint issues. Once again, a little bit off the side. The teeth look good though, and I kind of love the crazy expression. I don't like how they assemble it. Like, they just cut out the jaw and they stuck it in there, so they have a line on there. If you're gonna do that, at least have it move. I don't know. Then you have a pizza, one piece of pizza, and there's another thing about this one. There's like a salami or whatever this is supposed to be. This is just painted on there. It's not even molded on there. What is that? This is just a red dot. It doesn't make any sense. Everything else looks good. Pizza is also in there. I cannot take it out and you have some cheese on top. Yikes. Somebody sat on that bomb, so what the hell is that about? And you have the grappling hook. It's not movable. Cannot get this in. It's just soft plastic and the turtle logo and a real rope on it. Bit of a string. Then you got the holding hands, which I actually got out, and the posing hands, or, you know, just kind of have a pizza on there, or just, it's kind of grabbing, but kind of not. Oh yeah, and also it does come with two painted ninja stars. And it's gonna do it, it's gonna bring me to the final thoughts for this Michelangelo, and it's like, yeah, it's another turtle. And it's the same mold, it's the same thing, with some small differences here and there. So I always praise the Super 7 Turtles, and this one's no different. Unfortunately, this one has a little bit of quality control issues. Here and there, small things, not the worst thing in the world. Also, I talked a lot about joint tolerance. I just gotta say, though, getting this guy back into post, it's a lot of fun. And there's, like the knees and elbows, that's, like, stuff that is a lot more... I almost wanted to say semi-ratcheted, because it kind of snaps into place and it does help with the posing. Also, by the way, I had like the other set of holding hands, which do have the hinge that goes up and down, just for clarification, because we had the hinges before that go left and right. So, what does that mean? I do recommend this one. It is a very solid release for the Turtles. It's a different version, and I really praise the idea of making cartoon Turtles, updating them. It's something else, it's something different, and it's chock-full of nostalgia and executed very, very well. So, yeah. I don't have anything much more to say about it. It's just like I'm saying, those Super 7 Turtles, they're pretty good. That's gonna do it, guys. As usual, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget, if you enjoyed this review, hit it up with a like and subscribe to the channel so you can stay tuned for more figure reviews, card game stuff, and whatever Michelangelo wants.